Hello kid, today I am going to tell you a story. Well, this story is about a family of sparrows. See, they had recently shifted to a new place. Do you know where was that? Well, it was just beside the pond where a family of ducks used to live. Well, the ducks were very happy to see the new family of sparrows. So what did they do? Well, they invited them to have lunch with them. So the sparrows came and together they started the party. They saw the ducks were eating very nicely. But poor sparrows could not eat anything. They were trying again and again, but they couldn't eat anything. Do you know why is that? Let me explain it to you. Well, over here we see three different types of food. For the first one, which is a steak, we need to use a knife with which we need to cut the steak and have it. The second picture is of soup. Now, can you have the soup with the help of knife? No. For that, we have a special spoon which helps us to have soup. The third picture has got noodles. Now, can we have noodles with knife or this soup spoon? Not really. For that, we need a fork. So, we have got different cutlery to have different types of food. In the same way, if you see, over here, there are different types of birds and they have different types of beaks. See, the beaks are very different from one another. So, just like for particular food, we have the cutlery which helps us to eat. Similarly, for the birds as well, we have got the beaks which help them to eat. Now, some birds feed on seeds and for that they have these kinds of beaks, whereas some of them eat meat and flesh. For that, they have got a different type of beak. So, let's know it in details. Well, here we see that there is a glass of juice. Now, can you drink it with the help of this spoon? No, it is not possible. So, how can you drink it? Well, with the help of a straw. The straw will help you to suck the juice from the bottom of the glass and have it. In the similar way, the hummingbird, which is a small bird which flies backward, has got a straw-like beak which helps it to suck nectar from the flower. So, what did we see here? The hummingbird has straw-like beak. Why is it so? Because the straw-like beak of hummingbird helps it to suck nectar. Now, what do you do when you have to eat a walnut? Either you break it with the help of a walnut cracker or you break the outer covering with the help of your teeth. For similar types of food which have got outer covering that is hard, well, the sparrows have got triangular short beaks which are strong and they help them to break the outer covering of the seed and eat it eventually. So, here we see that the sparrow has a triangular strong beak and these help them to break the hard outer covering of seeds. Now, did you notice one more thing? Well, the sparrow has got these toes. Do you know why are they so helpful? Because these toes of a sparrow help it to hold the branch of the tree very firmly. See over here, in this picture, the sparrow is holding on to the branch with the help of its toes. Now, what is this? Do you know? Well, this is a pair of tongs. And why is it used for? Well, if we want to hold something very, very firmly, we use tongs. See, with the help of these, he is holding this food. Now, in the same way, some of the birds have got beaks like tongs, which help it to catch the fish and hold on to it strongly. So, these types of beak are found in fish-eating birds, like the great blue heron. See, this is a fish-eating bird, and this bird has got spear-shaped beaks, which help them to catch fish. See, with the help of this beak, it is catching the fish. Now, some of the birds, like the duck, have got flat spoon-shaped beaks. Do you know why? Because these help them in filtering out the aquatic plants and have them as food. So, here we saw the duck. And what type of beak does it have? Well, it is flat spoon-shaped. And how does it help the duck? Well, it helps the duck to eat by filtering aquatic plants and animals. See, this is the beak. Now, what do you do when you get a bowl of soup? What do you use to have it? Well, you use a spoon to have the soup and not the fork. Well, for the steak, what do you do? To have this steak, you use knife and other cutlery. Now, over here, we see there is a type of bird which catches the prey and it eats its flesh with the help of its strong, sturdy beak. So, these types of birds which hunt and feed on rodents and other small animals are known as raptors. What are they known as? They are known as raptors. They are the flesh-eating birds. They first hunt their prey and then they hold on to it with the help of its claws. And finally, with the help of its curved beak, it tears the flesh and has it. So, these are some of the examples of raptors. First, we have the falcon and then we have got the eagle. Now, what do they have? Well, they have got claws and they have got curved beaks. So, over here we can see raptors' claws are very strong and sturdy. See, these are the claws which help them to hold on to its prey. So, since the claws are very strong and sturdy, they help them to catch the prey and hold on to it. And finally, they have their strong curved beaks, which help them to tear the meat. So, I have a question for you. Which of the following birds is a raptor? Is it option 1, duck, or option 2, sparrow, or option 3, eagle? Well, the correct option is option 3, eagle. It is a flesh-eating bird which hunts its prey and holds on to it with the help of its claws and finally tears the meat and eats it with the help of its beak. So, duck is a wrong option and so is sparrow. So now, after all the food groups, we have got the birds who feed on insects. Insects are high in protein and the birds love to have it. Well, the insect-eating birds have some specialities. Look at the beak. Well, here you can see they have got long, thin bills. That is this one. So, how does it help the bird? Well, the long, thin bills of insect-eating birds help them dig into the mud to look for the insects hiding there. So, since these birds feed on insects, they have got these special beaks which help them to dig into the mud and find out the hiding insect in it. Now, over here is a very clever bird. That is the woodpecker. See, it keeps on hitting the bark again and again to make the hole and feed on the insect. So, what is this bird known as? This is the woodpecker. So, over here we see the woodpecker has got strong pointed beak. See, with the help of this beak, what does it do? Well, it makes it act as a chisel and a crowbar, which help them to remove the bark and find the hiding insect. So, with the help of this beak, he makes a hole in the bark and finds out the hiding insect. So now, my dear kid, you have seen that just like we human beings use different types of cutlery to have different types of food, similarly, the birds have different types of beak so that they can have the food that is good for their body. So, beaks and claws help the birds to have their food. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. You can also register for free at deltastep.com to get all the learning resources as per ICC, CBSC, IB, Cambridge or any other curriculum. More than 5,000 plus amazing lectures across maths, science, English and social studies. Our unique interactive video technology keeps you engaged and our iDictionary feature allows you to quickly revise any concept. Master each topic at your own pace with our adaptive practice technology and 1 million plus questions. Get instant answers and detailed solutions. Be exam ready by taking unlimited mock tests. Performance analysis along with actionable feedback. Personal tutors to resolve your slightest of doubt. That's not all. You can also win amazing prizes like PlayStations, iPads, watches and many more along with certificates through our Earn As You Learn program. So, at deltastep.com, learning is not only fun and easy, but also rewarding. So register for free now.